Welcome back in LADALIDI. And for today's video, I'm going to talk about the neuomorphism or neumorphic style. And for those of you who don't know what neuomorphism design, don't skip this video yet. But before explaining briefly what neuomorphism is, it's better if we know skeuomorphism first. Sounds the same and visually looks the same. As an illustration to distinguish them, skeuomorphism is a term used in the user interface to create a component like a real component in the real world. One example of the application of skeuomorphism is the recycle bin shortcut icon in the Windows OS. Skeuomorphism was popularized by Apple on its iOS, at the beginning of the era of touchscreen smartphones. By applying skeuomorphism, users who initially didn't understand how a touchscreen works can adapt faster. For example, buttons with glossy effects, photos with white borders like real photos in the real world, or 3D buttons that almost resemble their shapes in the real world, and many more. This design then quickly spread and applied to other platforms. The use of this skeuomorphism style design does not go out of its function to introduce users to touchscreen buttons. For now, it is rare to find designs with a skeuomorphism style, because almost all people in the world are familiar with digital media. So, the use of skeuomorphism that is too detailed will be useless, because the user can interpret a component quickly, even though it does not resemble a component in the real world. Neuomorphism was born from the combination of skeuomorphism and flat design, so as to produce a 3D design, textured, but still soft and simple. Such output can be produced with the right blend of shapes, gradients, background colors, highlights, and shadow play. At first glance, you may think that you need a 3D rendering application, but actually you only need a standard design application that you usually use, such as XD, Figma, Sketch, and the like, with a little magic touch in its creation. So for this video I will not show you how to create a neuomorphic design with the application design that I mentioned earlier, but will show you how to create a neuomorphic design using Adobe Illustrator. Just open the Adobe Illustrator and create a new document with RGB color mode. RGB color mode is used to digital image, like digital artwork, UI design and many more. Create a background with light gray. First, I'll show you how to create a popping up button in a very simple way compared to the neuomorphic button I created in my previous video. First of all, create a square using the rectangle tool, with a size of 300 by 300 pixel. By the way, all the sizes I use in this video are based on the document size, which is 1920 by 1080 pixels. If you find the square size is too small, or too big, it means you have a document that is not the same as the one I have in this video. Back to the topic. I will make this box round in the corners. Go to the window menu and look for transform. In the transform panel, you will see the corner type where you can define the corner type for this square. You can choose round, inverted round, and chamfer. Then input the value right next to it and you can do it in all corners. For this neuromorphic button, I will only use the round type. Before filling in the value for the corner radius, I will activate this chain icon. Its function is that all corners have the same value as the value we input on only one of the corners, and I'll give it a value of 50 pixels, and all corners will follow. This saves time instead setting the corner sizes one by one. Then give it the same color as the background color. Use the eyedropper tool and sample the background color. After the color is same, then we will give it a shadow. Go to the effect menu. Style. Drop shadow. In the drop shadow panel, make sure it's black in multiply mode. After that, give the opacity 10%. X offset, 20 pixels. Y offset, 20 pixels. And blur, 20 pixels. And click OK. Now we're going to give it a highlight for the top side. Duplicate this rounded square. Open the edit menu. Copy. Go back to the edit menu and select paste in place. In the window menu, open the appearance panel. If you see it's already has a drop shadow, it's because we have given a drop shadow effect to the rounded square that we have duplicated. We just double click it to modify it. In the drop shadow panel, change the color to white. Also change the drop shadow mode to normal. Opacity to 50%. X offset, minus 20 pixels. We add a minus because we are going to place this white shadow opposite the black shadow. Also add a minus for the Y offset. and blur leave it at 20 pixels, and click OK. Now, we have finished the popping up button with neomorphism style in a simple way with Adobe Illustrator. Next, I'll show you how to make the popping down button. For this popping down button, we don't need to create a new rounded square. We just duplicate the previous one to get the same size. Press the Alt key and place it next to the other. Open the Appearance panel. Select the Drop Shadow effect and delete it by clicking the Delete Selected Item button. We don't need this shadow because for this popping down button we need the shadow to be inside the rounded square, not by giving it an automatic shadow but by creating it manually. Before that, color the stroke with black. The first thing we do is make it transparent, but only for the fill, not for the stroke. Actually, we don't need to make it completely transparent. We just need to remove the fill. By activating the fill on the toolbar, and remove it by pressing the None button below it. Open the Effect menu. Blur. Gaussian Blur. Change the radius to 20 pixels. Before making the white shadow, it's a good idea to resize it first so we can easily adjust it. Open the Transform panel in the Window menu. And resize it to 350 by 350 pixels. Okay, that's enough for the black shadow. For the white shadow, we just have to duplicate it. Open the Edit menu. Copy. Go back to the Edit menu and paste in place. Move this new rounded square so we can see the difference. Give white color to the stroke. Double-click the stroke in the toolbar to give it a white color. Then change the stroke weight to 10 pixels. At this step we no longer need to give it a blur effect because we are duplicating the previous rounded square that already has a blur effect, and we have done creating the white shadow. Next, open the Edit menu. And paste in place. Open the Appearance panel and remove the blur effect. Change the size back to 300 pixels, according to the size of the popping up button that we made earlier. To make it easier for us to distinguish these three rounded squares, I will enable Outline mode. Open the View menu and select Outline. In this way, we can clearly see these three rounded squares. This is a rounded square for the black shadow, and this is for the white shadow. And the middle one is a normal rounded square. Select the black shadow first and align it with the normal rounded square on the top like this. And for the white shadow, align it with the rounded square at the bottom. After everything is set up like this, go back to the View menu and activate View mode. Or with the short key, Ctrl plus Y on the keyboard. The last step, select these three rounded squares. Right click. And select Make Clipping Mask. And here we are, with two buttons popping up and popping down in a neomorphism style with a very simple and fast technique by using Adobe Illustrator. With this technique we can create various kinds of neomorphism style buttons. You can combine it with gradient colors like this. Or with other colors like this. You can also experiment with more complex shapes like this one. For the next video, I'll show you how to create a more complex neomorphism style design like this one, so don't hesitate to press the subscribe button and activate the notification bell, because I will be making new tutorial videos every week. If you have any questions, please ask me in the comments. And don't forget to like and share if this tutorial helps. See you in the next week.